Hello?
Miss Whitman, it's Dr. Jens. I have some bad news.
What's wrong with you, Princess? Where won't you spend?
This one looks quite serious.
Matthew knew it was hopeless. Nothing mattered anymore. Mr. White's body was melting, even as Matthew watched. The snowman could no longer speak. The happy face Matthew had loved now was nothing but slush. Matthew stared up into the sky, watching the winter's last snowflake floating down. Some said its touch held the power of magic, but Matthew had lost his faith in stories. But when the snowflake finally touched Mr. White's outstretched arm, a coating of fresh frost spread out over it, and a puddle of water under the snow
talk.
I can talk.
Are those your parents?
That's my mom. She got sick and she's dead now. My dad's a pilot.
Is he dead too?
He's not dead. My dad's Theodore Whitman. He's a hero. He saved all of his passengers from a tornado, but he crash-landed. And when he gets rescued, he'll come and get me.
Nobody here has any parents.
Lights out!
Good night, Tom.
Princess.
It's good to see an old friend. I was just standing there in the backyard, minding my own business, and I felt this sting on my arm. I think it was that little thing. Tom lets you and me take a trip. See where it goes next. Who knows? Maybe we'll bump into someone you used to know. Encounter things you've only dreamed of.
I'm dreaming. That's why everything's so weird.
So come on. It'll be fun. You'll be safe. Listen, buddy, if you're too scared to come along, I understand. Maybe you're not a chip off the old block. Don't worry about it. You can just go back to bed. Or you can come with me and have an adventure. Genuine oak.
Several times over the phone.
Yes, we have. But given his current condition...
You want to pull the plug?
Well, it's not quite like that. He's not on life support. Though his heart did stop twice. Each time we brought him back, but to keep doing it.
Where do I sign?
World for the last couple of years. He's regressed to childhood. I just think it would be cruel to him. I can reach you at your father's if you need to speak. I don't expect you'll be flying back in this weather.
No.
leave you too long.
Selfish and rude. Yep, that's the dumb.
You're hiding.
Not so nice now, is he?
Somebody thought it was a great idea to build in this godforsaken place.
Hey, wait! Do you know where the music's come from? I've heard it before.
You've heard it. Kid, we've all heard it. All day, every day. Same damn melody over and over again. Makes me sick. Jim.
Just leave it. It's lifeless.
Yes. Thank you. Let it rot. Be careful. Just the two of us. Two tickets to the circus. It'll be great, buddy. It's right around the corner. Let me show you.
Oh. Leave me alone. You're making this too weird.
Don't you walk away from me!
Okay,
I'm not mad.
Thank you. Go back to sleep.
Dad.
Is this about your mother again? Scared? How can you be scared of it if you've never even seen it? Huh? Huh? It's just a bunch of clowns. Trapeze artists. Wearing tights.
How did you get in here?
It's a magic trick. I can't reveal the secret, but it involved a brick.
Well, it's nice to see you.
What happened to you? You destroyed my life, you old bitch.
Nobody destroyed my life. You people just did what you wanted. Everyone for themselves, right?
It's unfair. It wasn't like that.
Really? What was it like? Because the band and the tours and the money and all that stupid crap, that all seemed a lot more important to my dad than anything that had to do with me or my mom. And even when he was home, he was never here. He was always lost inside his own mind. Anyway, I don't care. You may have unresolved issues with Tom. I don't.
Oh, yeah. I can see that.
Well, it's not like I've ever really been a part of his life, so...
You were always the most important part of his life. Yeah, that's better. I don't know why he had to put the bad ones up, too. He just could never let go.
Oh, cute. You used to be a happy kid.
Used to be. And thanks to him.
All he ever wanted was to forget everything and move on with you. Of course, didn't work out.
You know, Anne, it was a long time ago. You really should just let it go.
When you get old enough, you don't fear death anymore. You wait for it. And after a while, you hope for it, even if you don't admit it. You know why? Because losing your mind before you go is worse than dying. You hope you'll check out before your brain turns to mush.
Yeah, well, you still seem pretty sharp.
I'm talking about your father. He's in a dark place right now. Doesn't it bother you not knowing how he remembers you?
No. I think it bothers you more. If he remembers me at all, it's a something that was broken and then put back together. He was never really good at fixing things.
He did the best he could.
You ought to be more careful. Else you're going to turn this into a nightmare.
You're hurting me.
You know I would never do that. I only want what's best for you.
Thank you. Thank you. digits do these things usually have?
I don't know. Just don't try the brick, it won't work.
We need to get this stupid thing open.
Why, Anne?
Because when Tom locks something away, it's important.
You didn't have any money. You guys pissed all of it away.
A little bitter, are we?
About having to pay for his care? Actually, yes, I am.
You did a good thing. You let him stay here, at home, with his memories. Not so bad for somebody who doesn't care about her father.
What were my options? It was either that or have every goddamn family friend drown me in guilt.
Nonsense. This family's been pretty well out of friends for at least a decade, sweetheart.
I wonder why. What with Tom being so famous for caring about people?
I keep telling you, he cared. Something that he knew he would never forget. What a cliche.
What's in there?
Thank you.
So, satisfied now, are we?
Yes. Because this is what I grew up with. Scattered pages, songs, words of wisdom, fairy tales all around me. You see that thing? His precious arabesque. His princess. He said the dancer inside would spin if I managed to play the chords right when I was learning the piano.
Oh, yeah.
No. His idea of raising me was to feed me these endless pipe dreams and weird monologues. Because everything was a performance to him. And he did the same thing to my mom. He strung her along, kept making and breaking promises, and she always believed him. Always. And he always disappointed her because you came first. And she ended up dead. I hope it was worth it. Oh, shit. Bonjour, mon général. This is how small I was in his magical musical world. Do you know, he'd written songs for everyone around him. Maybe even for this little bastard here. But never, never for my mom or me.
To find your way.
What's happening? What is it?
Well, the battlefield, sir. You fought in this room for many years. Huh? I'm ashamed that I've wounded you so grievously and for nothing.
No,
please, sir, don't spare my feelings. It was a mighty blow I struck. I can only beg. Forgiveness.
I stepped on you.
I ambushed you. But, sir, my motives were pure. It was a brave attempt to stop you from going with the accursed snowman. That evil pig. It's the memories, sir. He takes them. You further in the darkness.
Why?
You got old. Still, you've got the best of him, at least for now. The best memories hurt him. You've chased the very best one.
Edgar?
Yes! Your daughter! What a girl! What a memory! Oh, so magnifique! You remember her best for the things you both shared as children, like myself or the pretty mademoiselle within the glass bubble. Yes, you loved us well. And so did your daughter.
I don't remember.
Oh, well, there's nothing to be done then. Savvy? This is as far as we go. Sir?
need your help. I need to remember her. I need to find her. I took some pills, but I didn't take enough because I woke up and then when I did, Tom was there. I didn't plan it that way. I was sure. He stayed with me. But he would not look at me. Not after what I had done.
Yeah, well, I bet that little stunt really screwed with your precious band.
No.
Yeah, it was the end of the band. True, but no, you see, what I'd done was, I don't know, too personal for him. You don't know.
Know what?
Oh, Sam, honey, you don't know that Tom's father killed himself? Theodore Whitman shot himself in the head, and Tom watched it happen. What I did was hard on him. That night, your mother had the accident. That's what broke up the band. He didn't care. But he knew he was going to lose you as well.
Why are you telling me this? Because I don't think you know your father at all.
He worshipped Theodore in spite of his dark moods.
From what Tom told me, he would be really mean.
So, when Tom felt himself going down the same path, he pushed you away. I know. He pushed very hard.
Thank you.
say, sir, it has been a pleasure to serve you and yours.
It was cheap, shabby, and run down. And she was enchanted by everything she saw, laughing and squeezing my hand. First time I felt like a father watching her smile. Why couldn't you have just told me this?
He did tell you. In his way, the only way he knew. Oh, man. I was always hoping there might be something that would make it all worthwhile. Not this nonsense.
Oh, my God. These aren't just scattered thoughts or feelings. Look. Of her mother, my broken, missing love. So small but as wise and as beautiful as she was. I am proud of love. Now push her away.
She must not shun. I hope she understands. So this is where you stashed all the good stuff, huh? But this just took a bit of a beating, so you should see your little friends.
I know what you've been up to.
Congratulations. What did we learn, huh? Your daddy had his fill of you. Took his own life. The songbird tried the same trick. And there's your little girl. She hates you. Nothing left, if you ask me.
Seems like you don't have much left either.
I've got one thing. Magic. Light brings darkness. What sweet irony. It's your rule. Your rules. I wonder who dreamed that up. And here it comes. It's like watching your greatest fear come alive.
Thank you.
his mind.
So where's the last page?
Yep, it's the power. And of course, the phone's dead.
Not picking up her phone. Must be the storm. Thank you. adventure you'll ever have, buddy. Thank you.
Clearly now, the most beautiful melody ever created by man. Thank you.
want you to be mine.